when she entered the room, what did she find? She found Ramchand in the same corner where she had left him, with the piece of dough still firmly in his hand. Firmly means tightly, okay? But he was crying. Now what he was doing? He was crying, and that dough was still in his hand. And he wasn't howling. Howling means crying very loudly, or throwing a tantrum. Tantrum means a bad, doing something means throwing things out of bad temper because he was angry, he was unable to make anything, okay? Or weeping like children do. He was really crying with a real heartbreaking sorrow, gulping and sobbing, his eyes full of grief. So he was not crying loudly, or he was not throwing things here and there out of anger. But what he was doing? He was crying with really heartbreaking. Heartbreaking means really very upset. He was sad. He was very sad. Heartbreaking sorrow means upsetting, pain, gulping, swallowing. Gulping means swallowing the food quickly. Okay, just not chewing properly, just gulping it. And sobbing. Okay, noisy crying. Sobbing means crying noisily. He was not crying loudly, but crying noisily. His eyes full of grief. Grief means sadness, sorrow. Pain tore through her heart. Seeing her child crying in that way, she felt very sad. She rushed to him and scooped him up in her arms. Scooped up means lift. She lifted him into her arms. Hugging him, hugged him, examining him to see if he had physically hurt himself. So, she quickly went to him and took him to his arms, to her arms, hugged him and really examined, checked that if he had physically hurt himself. But he hadn't. And she sensed, she could feel that he had not hurt himself. His eyes told her that. His eyes, when she looked at his eyes said that he is not hurt, but something else had happened. She murmured. Murmured means speak very softly to him. She crooned. Crooned means spoke softly, sang softly to him gently. And when he calmed down slightly, the sorrow and incomprehension. Incomprehension means failure to understand something. So after singing to him softly, after hugging him, then speaking to him, murmuring to him, when he slightly calmed down, then she asked him very, very seriously, "Tell me, why are you crying?" So after doing everything, after making his her son calm down, then she asked her son what was the matter. He didn't answer at first. He just looked down at the piece of dough in his hand. The look on his face more confused and miserable. So initially when his mother asked him what had happened, he did not answer. He just looked into his hand, to the piece of dough, and then his face looked more confused and miserable. Miserable means unhappy. He looked at the beloved familiar face of his mother. Then he looked at his mother. Okay, beloved means too loving. Dearly loved face of his mother. Her clear gaze met his with honesty. So she was clear. So she understood the honesty. He trusted her. So his son had trust in her, belief, faith in her. He could tell her, Ma, you said, you told me to make the most. So he could not speak properly as he was crying. So he was speaking in this way. He was stammering that, "Ma, you told me to make the most beautiful thing, but I could not. Okay, so he gulped, so he was unable to speak the full thing. Okay, then what did he do? She waited. You said make the most beautiful thing in the world. So she waited till her son could finish what he wanted to say. Then she said, and she asked, her face was still serious and inquiring. Inquiring means to learn more, want to know more. Then she asked her son, and what happened then?